Hallo zusammen! Every single language has their own funny, interesting, normal, but also pretty hideous and hilarious expressions. And even though they might not make much sense at first, they actually do. They actually do make sense, and people use them frequently and commonly and on a daily basis. What are those expressions about, those interjections? Let's learn a couple of them today. Number one, awa, or ow. So, you know what, let's actually turn this into a little quiz as well. So you've heard the expression, the interjection, awa, or ow. What could this refer to? I'm gonna give you, well, let's say 5 seconds to think about this from now on. Okay, so this was the first one, and it might also have been a quite easy one, I don't know. Because it's somewhat similar to the English expression that pretty much is the sister expression to this one. Ouch. Aua, or au, is an expression of rather sudden and often unexpected pain. Because, I mean, like, when is pain actually expected? There are some scenarios that come up in my mind right now, but let's not dive further into that. So, for instance, when you're German and you want to hammer a nail into a wall, you might actually yell, "Aua!" or "Au!" when you didn't hit the nail, but apparently your thumb. If that has never happened to you, you're lucky. You're a lucky person, but that really hurts. Das tut weh. A semantically similar German interjection that gets used comparatively less often is "Ouch!" Ouch! I'd even say that's an expression of pain you'd rather find in written than in spoken German. For instance, in, well, say, a comic strip. Ah! And that's as close as you can get to the English ah! ouch in German as well. Ah! By the way, it's die Interjektion singular, die Interjektionen plural. An interjection is pretty much a spontaneous and sudden linguistic verbal reaction to a specific situation or occurrence. Number two. Huch. What does that express or refer to? Huch. Time's already over. I almost didn't notice. Silly me. As you can see, huch is an expression of surprise. As a side note, and that is pretty much the reason why I came up with this video idea in particular, I personally pretty much associate this term strongly with one particular person. The popular German Let's Player Gronkh. In a lot of his Let's Play videos, he reacts to something unexpected by saying huch.
Aber ich muss sagen, bisher war unsere Huch, unsere neue Gegend war bisher beeindruckender als hier der Kappes. Doch, sieht gut aus. Huch, jetzt hapelt der hier ab und zu mal, aber ist ja auch ein Dschungelbiom.
Well, this would be a proper example.
Some Germans might rather say huch with a rather dark sounding U, whereas others might say huch or even huch with an increasingly lighter U, so to speak. And I'm almost certain there are many more ways to verbalize this term too. I really like this term because it sounds, dare I say, kinda cute. Number three. Nanu? What's your clever guess this time? As it's the case with pretty much all German interjections, they also work as a, well, single word sentence, pretty much, if you will. Nanu? What? It's empty already? It doesn't have to be intonated as a question, though. It can also be used as an exclamation. Nanu? It's another German expression of surprise, but nowadays it's used less often compared to a word like huch. The fourth term, oha, is very similar to nanu in the sense of it being a comparatively rare interjection these days. Thinking about oha as an interjection, it almost sounds stiff to me because I wouldn't use that, and Honestly, I can't think of a single person that has ever used that in a conversation. Maybe that's also a more written interjection than it's a spoken interjection. But either way, it is a really rare one these days, I'd say. And last but not least, tja. Again, have the cleverest guess of all clever guesses. And the cleverest ones of those as well. What could this be about? Tja, das ist eine gute Frage. Well, that's a good question. Here you have it. It's one of the many German equivalents to the English interjection, well, at the beginning of a sentence. And that's actually something all these interjections usually have in common too. If they aren't used as a single exclamation, as a one-word sentence so to speak, but rather in a sentence, they're pretty much exclusively implemented and used as the initial, meaning the first word. Do you know more typical German interjections? If so, tell us in the comments and I might feature your comment in a follow-up video to this one. Apart from that, I really hope you've enjoyed this and you've learned something. Thanks for watching, I'm your Vlog Dave, tschüss und bis zum nächsten Mal.